Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do your daily vibes for around the 31st. But keep in mind that the timing is fluid. We're just going to see what comes up. I chose this deck because I opened it up to my tug of war card. You know, the tug of war card I always talk about, you know, when they're playing tug of war. I picked up a couple of other decks, and I was like, I got to use my favorite deck. I don't know. I felt like I needed to use my favorite deck. So I picked it up, and I cut it. I cut it to the middle, and it was the Five of Swords. But I just cut it again. We got the Eight of Swords. It wasn't the Five of Swords. It was the Five of Wands, okay? It was the Five of Wands. It is Mercury retrograde, like, shadow, and it's about to be Mercury retrograde, and if anybody knows about Mercury retrograde, you know, it affects speech, so be prepared. Should be fun. Anyhow, Eight of Swords. This is somebody who's trapped in a prison of some sort. This could be somebody that's actually in prison. This is trapped behind bars, trapped behind thoughts. Somebody that is stuck, but they're not really. I mean, this person looks like they can escape. They can escape. There's a means of escape here. There is. They may be just waiting for somebody to come rescue them from this prison. Perhaps. Looks like this person isn't talking very much. They're not speaking up for themselves. Somebody needs to speak up and they're not. Perhaps they're allowing themselves to be stuck in this situation when they can get out of it. You can get out of it. It's like they're not even tied up. What do we got here? We have an obstacle. Somebody is allowing themselves to be stuck, allowing themselves to be trapped mentally. Now, Seven of Pentacles, this is about investment. It's time. It's time to pick. It's time to go someplace else. There's no more growth here. It's time to go someplace else. It's like you've done all you can do. This season is over. The season is over. King of Wands reversed. Now, the King of Wands reversed is somebody that is very controlling. This person can be manipulative, very unreasonable. This is an unreasonable person. You can't reason with this person. They think that they know it all. The Devil reversed. Now this is taking back control. This is a card of freedom. We're going to get some more cards. Justice. Justice. Now justice is about the law. All that is fair and just. It's about the law. This is about balance. Bringing balance and harmony back to a situation using the truth. What is the truth anyway? This is also a card of karma. So it looks like we have somebody here that has been in a state of confusion, or they still are. We could have somebody here that is very indecisive. They don't know what they want to do. They don't know what the right thing to do is. This person may be angry, may become angry in the next coming days. Somebody may get very angry. They may get upset, maybe because they're losing control. Okay. Maybe they're going to choose to give up control. Maybe that's the right thing to do, because the devil reverse, which is represented by Capricorn, is somebody that relinquishes control and does the right thing. This is a card of integrity. This is a Libra as well. So anyway, so this is where somebody breaks free from manipulation. They stop manipulating. They stop lying. They don't tell the truth. So interesting. But this person gets upset. This person is angry. Maybe angry, but may also be indecisive. You know, it's time. It's picking time. It is time. We do have a choice here. And the eights are the time is now. We have a couple of eights. And the first card was an eight. So 8, 8, 8. These eights are reversed. So there's been a lack of abundance. There's been a lack of growth. There's no more growth in a situation. It's like stuff is going backwards. There could be some jealousy. It feels as though there's a lot of emotions. Somebody gave up. Somebody didn't put in effort. Somebody may have walked away or is thinking about walking away. Somebody may have said goodbye. There's consequences for the actions. This is a card of consequences. Somebody may be suffering some consequences for not putting in effort, but for not doing what they were said they were going to do. There could be some consequences here. They didn't get what they thought they were going to get. Anyway, this is the devil reversed is releasing. It's releasing. It's a card of freedom. And this is a card of justice. Doing what is fair, doing what is right, making the right decision, being honest, being truthful. So somebody may decide to do the right thing and let go of an unhealthy, toxic situation. This is coming out of a toxic, unhealthy situation. Finally. This is finally. This is a final. Making a final decision after being indecisive and angry and upset. Trying to control. Somebody was really trying to control. But this trying to control wasn't giving them the outcome, the desired outcome. Interesting. But now we have justice. Justice is a card of integrity. Integrity. There could be some upcoming legal matters. This is about doing the right thing, making the right decision. Somebody is being weighed down by needing to make a choice, needing to make a decision. Opening up, letting go. Somebody has been holding on, and they've been selfish. Definitely selfish, selfish. Selfishly holding on to something, trying to prove a point. And now they may have some regrets. They're probably very anxious and depressed. Worried. Distraught. We do have somebody here that is distraught. This person, it's very heavy. It's a very heavy energy. Somebody is feeling like so confused. What should I do? What should I do? That's what we got here. We have somebody here that is very, very much thinking about whether they should relinquish control or hold on to it. There's consequences. This is a card of consequences. There's consequences for the decisions and the choices that you make. Somebody has a better option. They have a better choice. So they need to really think about the next step. And I think that's what we have here. It's all about love. It's all about love. Okay? You got to go with what your heart says is right. You got to go with love. It's all about love. There's a new opportunity for love. There's also an opportunity for a reconciliation here of some sort. This could be a new love or a reconciliation. This is opening up. This is sharing. This is sharing the love. This is doing the right thing. You know, everybody deserves to be loved. Love should come first. Love should come before control in society. We have somebody here who was very much worried about what society was going to say. These are both very much, society driven. Anyhow, but now there's some sort of regret. There's worry. Despair. Somebody may be even feeling guilty. Guilty for their poor decisions. But the Four of Pentacles reversed is opening up. It's letting go. Letting go in the name of love. I'm going to let this go. I'm going to stop. I'm going to stop right now. I'm going to do the right thing. I'm going to stop being so controlling. I'm going to stop doing the wrong things. And I'm going to let go in the name of love. Let's hope that's the case. We could be dealing with a father. We could be dealing with a father who is angry and upset and doesn't want to let go of control. It's hard. It's hard when you are a masculine to let go of control. But it's all about integrity. It's all about doing the right thing. Keep in mind that karma is real. When you do not act with integrity and you do not do the right thing, be prepared for it to come back to you later on in life when you least expect it. This is making a final decision to let go of something. And you let go of it and it leads to an abundance of love. Ooh, have faith. Faith. Have faith and trust. Believe. Believe that there is a reason. Believe that there is a higher power involved. It feels as though we have somebody here that is being divinely guided to open up and to let go of control. It's like their gut is telling them. It's like God is helping them. It's like they're being told. And I feel like somebody's prayers are also going to be answered. We could have somebody that is very worried and has been begging for freedom, begging for freedom from whatever prison they're in. They may be begging, just begging. That's what I feel like this is. Begging for justice, begging to be loved, begging. And it's like, this is like God. It's like a higher power. It's a higher power, okay? Whoever your God is. This is like a higher power saying, I hear you. I hear you. Let's do the right thing. Let's break free from this devil energy. Let's break free from this unhealthy, toxic situation that has no more growth. Let's do it. Now is the chance. The time is now. Now is your chance. Now is your chance to do the right thing. Right now, let's go. Let's go. Have no fear. Have faith and trust. Ooh. Now this is somebody moving very, very fast. This is very fast movement. Something happening very, very fast. Somebody is going to be moving very, very fast towards perhaps this Queen of Swords, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We have Taurus right here. We have Capricorn. We have Libra. We have Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. We have everybody, so it really doesn't matter because we all have these signs in our chart. This person knows the truth, is very factual, speaks the truth, is very authentic, and sees the situation absolutely clearly. This person knows what is up. She does. And she is a very quick thinker. She is calculating and she is assertive. She moves fast as well. So we have two people that are probably going to have a conversation. Looks like these people are going to be talking to each other. They're going to be talking, and it could be a difficult conversation by the looks of things. It probably could be a difficult conversation. This one is demanding the truth, and she's putting up a fight. She is putting up a fight. Here comes this one, ready to fight as well. Oh boy, that looks great. So, but you got to be careful because, But there is a higher power involved here. This higher power is bringing these two people together to talk. Let's talk. We're going to talk about this. There is an opportunity for a reconciliation, and there is an opportunity for love here. Something is going to happen very fast. The Hermit reversed. There could be some sort of crisis, honestly. Somebody is not fully awakened. They're not fully aware of what love really is. No shit. But that Four of Pentacles reversed, that is opening up. That is letting go. That is coming out of a stubborn situation and breaking free from an unhealthy situation. That would be your prison. Or breaking somebody out of prison. Somebody has been in a toxic situation based out of ego. This is letting go of ego. No kidding. I'm just going to do the right thing now. Fuck the ego. Fuck the ego. It's time to do the right thing. So we have some fast forward movement here. There's going to be a conversation between two people, and it's probably going to be It's not going to be very nice, okay? I can't even think of a nice word. So it probably won't be the nicest, easiest conversation, put it that way. It won't be. I don't think it will be. But there is love somewhere in this scenario. It's like there's still some sort of love. And we do have a new beginning here. So there's going to be a victory. This conversation is going to lead to victory. It's going to lead to success. This is the end of something. So it's like this is the end of a phase. It's the end of a cycle. This is a major completion of a cycle of something big. It looks like a decision, a final decision is going to be made. There is a higher power involved here that is bringing these two people together. It's going to happen very, very quickly. And it is whatever this is, it's going to lead to love, a lot of love. And it's going to lead to a major new beginning, a major new life. It's like that phase of your life is over. that phase, and that was a prominent phase. It impacted you in some way. It taught you a lesson. A lesson was learned dealing with that toxic situation. There was a lesson learned. Somebody may have learned how to control themselves, or they probably needed to learn that lesson by the looks of things. Anyhow, somebody may have learned what love really is and what love really is not. I do believe that there is going to be a final decision that is made to let go of something and start a new chapter. It's like that journey is over, that phase, that season is done. We do have an opportunity for love here, a brand new beginning. Somebody may be traveling very quickly. Like somebody may suddenly decide that it's time. Didn't I say that it's time to go? I think I did. I can't remember. It's time to go. It's time to go. Come on, let's go. It's time to go. We may have somebody here that is very afraid. This person in the Nine of Swords looks like they're very afraid. This person may be afraid of, you know, the person that was so controlling. They may have resent towards this person. They may have fear towards this person, which is sad. So anyway, we have a major new beginning here. It's the end. This is the end. It's the end of that last phase. It is. One more card. Oh, we got a happy family here. Happy, 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 happy. It almost feels like somebody is coming home. It's like somebody is coming home. That's what I wanted to say. Somebody is coming home. Permanently. There could be a new relationship. This could be a new relationship. I don't know. It could be. I feel as though this is some sort of, I honestly feel like this is, it's like the end of one relationship and the beginning of another. Because that's what the 10 is, a completion. And I think that there is a higher power involved. Somebody is breaking free from an unhealthy, toxic situation where somebody was scared, somebody was fearful, somebody felt like they were in prison. And it's like they're headed towards freedom. They're headed towards happiness. They're headed towards bliss. They're headed towards love very, very quickly. And it's because somebody sees, it's like they wake up. It's like they wake up and it's like, I gotta go. I gotta go. I gotta go. It's time to go. One card, please. Judgment. Somebody is going to make a judgment call. This may have to do with the law. It may. Judgment. I understand that everyone has their own unique path and challenges. I feel as though today is a day of somebody opening up and letting go of an unhealthy situation. It's like they just decide to open up and let go. They decide to do the right thing. Because love matters more than anything. And we have a major completion with these tens. It is. It's a completion. It's like a big completion, not just a little one with the World card. Something big has completed, and it was a phase that was very prominent in your life. That's over. There's no going back. So I feel like now it's a release. It's a release and it's a new beginning. So we do have a new beginning here. I mean, what more can I say? There's going to be a talk. There's going to be a talk between two people that happens suddenly. It's like it's just like that. It's all of a sudden you're talking. And this talk leads to some sort of victory. This is a victory. It's over. So one phase is over. So, I mean, I don't need to keep going. It's the end. It's the end of what was. It's the end of what was and the beginning of something new. And whatever this new beginning is, it's going to be emotionally fulfilling. It's going to fill somebody's heart up with joy. It is. After they have felt rejected and alone, they're going to be loved. Good luck.